Well, Tom and Gene, no real fireworks today. No surprise, really, given how much time there still is on the clock. For now, it's all about boosting name recognition for these two former state senators and a newcomer looking to shake things up. In the first state-level debate of this election year, the Democratic candidates did their best to introduce themselves to the voters. Maggie Hassan was quick to point out her leadership credentials.
As Senate Majority Leader, I stood up for what was right and for middle-class families. And I have a record that reflects my ability to turn vision into practical solutions.
Jackie Silley introduced herself as a millworker's daughter from Berlin and says northern and western parts of the state are being left behind because they can no longer attract jobs and businesses.
There's no magic formula. They need education investments, transportation and communication investments. My administration will be dedicated to making just such investments. We leave nobody behind.
Veteran and small business owner Bill Kennedy calls himself the moderate alternative.
I'm the first to step out with a recommendation for a 4% flat rate income tax, and that will be caveated only by a significant reduction in the property tax.
Hassan is the only Democratic candidate who has taken the pledge against a broad-based tax.
I oppose an income or sales tax and would veto one if it comes to my desk. And that is because I believe it is the wrong thing for our economy, which is structured around not having an income or sales tax.
Silley says she'll be open to everyone's ideas as governor.
We have seen something less than that in our current legislature. The unwillingness to talk, to have a conversation, to look at compromise, none of those are bad words.
Kennedy is pitching himself as a, quote, common man.
I give you an alternative, a fresh alternative, a man with common sense, making common goals for a common good.
And there will eventually be a debate for the Republican candidates, Ovid Lamontagne and Kevin Smith. But right now, a date is still in the works. Adam Sexton, WMUR News 9.